out here this morning and we're going to take down the cherry tree. I'm going to shoot this in portrait rather than in landscape so that you can see what we're doing. Amos is going to start off by taking off the smaller limbs. You notice he has gloves on. He has safety glasses on. We do have the chainsaw out here, which is a small electric one that we use around the yard. But we're going to get the small stuff off first, so here's a picture of it before we get started, and we'll be back to show you one later. I forgot to point out there's that convenient bench that Amos can stand on, so hopefully we won't have to use a ladder too much. Oh, here's the barrel full of leaves, and then you can see that we cut up some of the wood here. We'll use it in that fire pit that I made that really pretty cover for. And cherry wood makes great barbecue, pork or chicken. It's just really excellent. There's some bigger pieces over here that Amos cut up. I still have to pick up. And then we'll go back over to the tree here and you'll see that we're down to nothing but big stalks. We're gonna take it down in as big a pieces as we can now because I have a friend who has a lathe and she wants to make some table legs out of it and also a table stand. So, we're going to make use of it all, okay? We're not going to, just because he wasn't happy here and was a little bit diseased, his base wood is good and it's going to be nice for somebody in the future. Amos has taken up the bricks around it so we can get in there. We're going to see what we can do about that stake that grew into it amongst the roots so we don't hit it with the chainsaw. But you can see that we've got quite a bit more wood here that we can chop up. And then here's the three legs that'll be for Sue's table when she does the dowel work that she intends to do on her lathe, okay? So working on getting that stake out of there, and it's probably under some roots, but we don't want to fall back into it when we're picking those apples. Can you see those?
Ah,
it broke. Yay.
It broke.
All right, we're good. So now he's going to take off the trunk. And we want to take it down there, Amos, where it tends to, get really small there so she
Actually,
can have the
give me that shovel back.
Whole
I'm
length
sorry.
Of it. Ah, he's going to... Well, not that one. He wants the trenching shovel.
I want this one.
You want that one?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to get around it.
All right. He's going to get around it, dig around it so he can get down below the graft. Because I don't know if you can see it there, but it gets really small and then it gets bigger. So we'll get that whole trunk for Sue so that she can use it for the bottom of her table. And Dad's out here too. Look, we'll pan around here and look at Dad. There's Dad, smile. There you go. Oh my goodness, okay. So, but see, the apple tree is full of apples, you can see there, and it's gonna be a whole lot happier to have some more air around it. So that's it for the moment. In fact, that's probably it for the project. We'll be taking off the trunk, but you don't need to see that. So I hope this was helpful.
You can see the last of it when you take off the trunk.
Yeah, you can see the last of it. And so I hope you find it helpful and you know how to take down a tree without too much difficulty and without hurting yourself.